So I think that we had quite many elephants in the room, and it's time to bring some falcons as well. What I'm going to present is not a result, it's actually work in progress, thinking in progress, and a plea to collaborate with existing clubs, because as you know, I come from Qatar, we still don't have a lab around. So we have interesting topics, but we don't have the exactly all the means to arrive to a good solution. Falcon is an old tradition, it's very broadly spread. There was a change of what role it played in the human societies. It's so important that it is included on the list of intangible heritage of UNESCO in 2016 after a proposal by 18 countries, more than the number of countries in Daria. I can say this because Sally is gone. And because we didn't have lots of examples of enjoyment, this is one snippet from an image from a book of ours from the British Library collection from the second quarter of 14th century, where we see a lady who is enjoying herself with a falcon hunting rabbits or hares. So falconry is considered to be so important in Qatar that this is part of the national identity. I got lots of passionate explanations about its importance, and local people say that it's not a sport but a way of life. And they also say that the traditional practice is preserved in Qatar particularly well. So I had to try myself how it looks like, just to make sure that I know what I'm getting into. And you can see that this is very similar, the previous image was very similar to the traditional one. But I have doubts following what Mia said, that we need to have questions and to ask questions. I have several questions. Can we say that the tradition is preserved as it was before if the hunting grounds now are different? If people keep the falcons in aviaries which have air conditioning, if they put radio frequency chips into the falcons to be able to trace them. Obviously these are things which change the whole place of falconry, but what is actually the tradition? How we can capture what is in this tradition? And I think our answer, if we come from the humanities side, is that we would want to collect narratives. Narratives from the present and narratives from the past. So where are these narratives in the case of falconry? I'm stealing an image from the interior design of the British Library, which has this ship metaphor, the ship of knowledge, and that's our falcon, which is on the time machine, where we have the present, the past, the distant past, and also the future. I put them around the time machine because, as I said, the claim is that the tradition is preserved as it was. So if we want to base our thinking on data, we would look at social media for the narratives of the present. We will look at oral histories for the past, which is not so distant, and we will look at all sorts of historical documents for the distant past. And why do I have the future here? All these narratives which we will be able to collect, process, are also part of what will feed the future ideas about falconry and what this tradition is about. So what are our challenges, very briefly? We don't have the wonderful Excel list of Mahendra to use in Qatar, so we have to dig for relevant content there. We have to deal with multilingual primary sources, so we need intelligent NLP technologies to be able to process at least Arabic and plenty of European languages. It's interesting who is involved in this area. We have falconry enthusiasts. We can do a lot of interesting intergenerational work with such a project, and this generally touches the general Qatari public in the country of Qatar. As I said, we can look at different sources, social media, historical sources, interviews, and plenty of images. We started A bit by bit creating a list of terminology, because we even don't have these very basic auxiliary tools, which normally we would need to classify different things. And at this point, as I said, we are looking for other institutions which might have labs and the desire to help us to dig into their content while we are trying to pull the local content in Qatar together. Thank you for your attention.